Charles and I settled here in the booth. This should be a fun one. Madden Ultimate Team matchup as you get a look at some of the stars here of today's game. Let's get right to it. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. First carry for LeGarrette Blount, and he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They'll run again with Blount, and he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. He lost two there, and it's third down.
I'm getting the sense that Fletcher Cox is making offensive linemen want to take the week off when they have to play against him.
It's a regular routine for him, isn't it?
It really is. That play there, that's him all day long. Good luck trying to block him and keep him from disrupting your offense.
Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. On fourth down, they snap it to Rivers. And this is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. And they'll run it for the first time with Ricky Williams. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
Really tough drive, but that run helped salvage something there because now there's something positive that came out of it. They got to see good blocking, good push by the offensive line, wide receivers trying to get involved, a good run by the back, and now maybe it'll be a catalyst for them to look at going forward.
In trouble, and he's taken down. They'll wind up losing 10 on the sack, and it'll lead to a third and long. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure it out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking scheme.
Trying to fight his tight end, Kelce, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Derek Johnson. And this one will be brought back to the 22. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. And that's going to be incomplete. The tight end, Gary Barnage, the intended receiver. Third down here.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to looking for Macklin, and it's intercepted. Picked off. It's the Pro Bowl corner, Joe Hayden, with it. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. First down carry, it's Williams. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
4 yards on the pickup there, as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground.
Oh, that's pure luck. He hit me and I fumbled the Well, I find that funny how that wasn't even the play I wanted to do. Oh, okay, I like that. I like that. I feel like what he's doing here.
It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. You know, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
They come up in an offset eye. Following the penalty, it's Williams. And he'll take this one down near the 15. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. And now it's a third and four situation for the offense. Beckham, the lone receiver right. Now it's Elway. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the two. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's San Antonio football here to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. And here comes play number six on this drive. First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And he's going to get this back to the 3 yard line and no further. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. So stuffed from the two. Now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
And from the three now, it's second and goal. They'll run it with Williams. Call it a gain of two as they're knocking on the door now. Third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal.
Partner's decision time now. I know it's still just the second quarter, but you have an opportunity to either kick the field goal or go for it and try and score a big-time touchdown. This is why the head coaches get paid the big bucks.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. They come out here in the eye. Play clock winding down. And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. John Elway taking it in. And his guys are able to strike for six. So they went for it from the one on fourth and goal, and they got it done.
Is this the new NFL?
This is the new NFL.
This is the updated NFL, and I like it. I know that quarterbacks across the league have spent the entire offseason and even during the season lobbying their coaches to go for it more on fourth down. Let's go get it, because nowadays you've got to score points to win games in the NFL. You can't just rely on your defense to hold them.
I think the quarterbacks want to eliminate field goals inside of 30 yards, probably.
Well, listen, they have enough confidence in themselves that they can call plays and make plays that they won't need those field goals inside the 30.
They start on the ground here with Blunt. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Whenever I go to a team's practice facility and watch them work, I love to watch the defensive guys in what they call pursuit drills. The ball goes either towards them or away from them. How fast will they respond? On this play, the defensive end responded better than anyone and made a really nice play.
Rivers now, the throw on first down.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense in every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
Well, Blunt, the lone running back. Now a play fake here on first down. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
A second down throw for Rivers. Ebron caught left side. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. Be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback has to slide and find open space to throw.
On the toss, this is Blunt. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3 yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
I like the call. Inside the red zone, running the toss. Why? They want to get to the edges. They want to see if guys who don't normally make a lot of tackles are willing to actually do that. That usually means the guy's at the cornerback position.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
And his kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
And here now the offense heading back out there. Now the ball banked way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
On first down, Elway steps away to his left. And some room to work. Call it a 3 yard gain, and it'll be second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
One receiver left, three to the right. Here we go now. On second down, Elway. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And they'll get him down here at the 23. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. From the gun on third down, it's Elway. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Now here's a whistle and a timeout. It's called by the receiving team here. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. Back deep is Devin Hester. Try and keep this away from Hester as this is going toward the sideline. And this punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Throwing Rivers. Look back at the time. Now he'll let this one go deep left sideline. And it's knocked away and incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. So here they come, the road team now getting the football first to start this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you turn that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And that'll make it third down. But pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up in the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. And quickly, they get to the line. They go play action here on first down. On the right side, caught by Green. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
Out to his left, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time, when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the...
Looking for Barnage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. So they go on fourth down. Not only do they not get it, it turns into 6 points the other way. Disastrous.
And many people think you should just go ahead and knock it down in that situation. Turn it over for the offense. But I had a defensive coordinator recently tell me, we see that as a passive play. We don't do that anymore. We want the ball in our hands, and we want to head the other way.
Probably also instinct a lot of times. If you see a lot of green grass ahead of you, go ahead and grab it.
It's the exact right play to do. That's knowing when to break the rules and when to make a play that maybe you hadn't been taught.
That's fielded in the end zone. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
They're going to hurry back to the line now. Again, here's Here's Blunt, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They'll try to throw here. Rivers throwing middle, and it's complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And that's one of his advantages of a passer is now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Love the call by the offensive coordinator, recognizing the situation very well, calling for the play-action pass, and completing it.
That throw good for 4. It's second down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Play action now. Rivers. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve, and that's what they did on that play. They went there.
And he will take this one in for a touchdown. Ryan Tannehill from 19 yards away. And his guys have made this a one-score game now. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Tyreek Hill on the return. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now this offense ready to take over again. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff.
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's rough.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And the return will stop right around the 25. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And now they're in the hurry up. Rivers to throw it. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
If you're running out route, it's likely you're going to end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Rivers. And this one caught by Coates. 14 yards that time for number 14.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did. Ready?
They'll throw again. Rivers flushed out right. And that one's going to be over everybody in the back of the end zone. It's incomplete.
Hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two. Now third down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Third and goal for Rivers. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And a short return will be stopped inside the 10 at the 8-yard line. And now back out comes the offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now.
All right, here we go.
Elway down around his goal line. They complete it to Hill. That catch good for five. It's third down. Now, defensively here, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. 9 yards to go. It's third down.
Hurry up. Here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Here's Elway. They'll set up the screen. This is Williams. And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. And now whistles blow here. Play is stopped, and we're going to get a timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And he's able to get it out of there, and this is a pretty good kick. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. He'll look to throw. Over the middle here to Coates. And he's brought down after a good game. A gain of 32 that time.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
And they're going to go soft on the corners, and they're going to hurry back to the line now. He's back to throw, and that is incomplete. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
And that incompletion was caused by the defense. I think they were trying to get one into the middle of the field, trying to find a receiver there. But they were in zone defense. And what are the advantages of being in zone? Eyes and reaction. Eyes meaning all eyes are on the quarterback and able to react when he throws the football and rally to that spot. And that's exactly what happened there. Able to get there and knock it away.
Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. And they're going to speed things up here. Here's Blunt, and his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And down by five, they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Fresh set of downs here. Blunt, the lone running back. Back to throw. That's complete, right around the eight. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
They'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl safety, Cam Chancellor. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. And here now the offense heading back out there. The clock cannot be stopped here. Defense can't do anything. So kneel it down, take it home.
No doubt about it. It's what you practice for in winning situations each and every week. Victory formation. Take a knee and go on into the locker room and celebrate.
Call it a victory. Well, partner, even though my phone alarm failed me this morning and missed our AM workout, we still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you, so it doesn't matter. But thanks for sharing a boot, and thanks for being our quarterback.
Yeah, you're the quarterback. Always a pleasure, my friend. So that'll do it for Charles Davis, the rest of our crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This has been a presentation of Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.